If you look closely in and around Minnesota Avenue in downtown Kansas City, Kansas, you'll see some amazing murals. And each one tells a story.
There's a very strong Hispanic presence in Kansas City, Kansas, like there is throughout the whole Kansas City area. Every state of Mexico is technically here, so we knew right there we were going to celebrate the different cultures that were here by putting the traditional dresses and trajes from the area, along with a little semblance of what the dance was about. And if you're in Mexico and you go to these different states, it's almost like going into different countries in some ways in how rich and ingrained each one of these traditions are. We're painting up on that wall, and people are coming by and going, oh my God, that's Puebla. That's where I'm from. And somebody will tell us, I danced this dance, you know, they knew it. And then I'm painting, and somebody comes by and says, where's Chiapas? You know, it's like, okay, I'm gonna be upset if you don't put Chiapas up there, because they knew it. For any immigrant that comes here, they never forget home. It's weaving what home was into a new fabric, into what community is here. And I think that's what that mural really represents in a lot of ways.
The mural behind me is the Wyandotte Nation mural. Myself and Joe Faust and an artist from Pascal Indian Nations University worked on the research and the design of the mural. A lot of the objects are based on different mythological stories from Wyandotte culture. One of them is the story of the earth being built on the back of a turtle, that the frog that you see in the image actually goes down to the bottom of the oceans, brings up the earth, lays it on the back of the turtle for the earth to be formed.
This was one of the murals where we decided that we were going to work with the youth in the community. What I like about the kid murals is that we said to the kids, look, you guys are going to be responsible for all the research. You're going to be responsible for coming up with the design. And then you're going to be responsible for painting this thing.
It's the first time they've ever done that. And with the actual youth members leading and choreographing the mural and design.
And what this story tells is that it's very simply done. They knew from their parents telling them that it was a very agricultural-based community. And the proof of that for them was that a lot of the Hmong will have gardens. Said, okay, the old culture was agrarian. And then over here, what remains of that is that we have our own little gardens. So the idea was to show life as it is now, with the garden being the thing that ties you up.
This mural is called Avenue Chronicles, and it spans across from the beginning towards the Depression to the 1930s and into Reconstruction, where the United States starts coming back after the wars and stuff. And the main focus of this mural here was based on film, because as you know, film has been recording history since the 30s.
I like the fact that it is a form of art that the community can take ownership of. Pretty much you don't need an appointment to go in. You don't have to wait for opening hours like you would a museum or a gallery. If you just drive by, you can see it. You can go right up to it. You can take pictures in front of it. It belongs to everyone. It doesn't just belong to one person who's bought a painting.